What's going on, y'all? It's your boy, KB.
Hey, what's going on? It's Marty.
It's Bernie from Social Club.
What's up, y'all? It's the Kid Flame, Clearside Music on deck.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy, Enrico.
What's up, world? It's your boy, Mike Real.
And they made us do this, so shout out to CHH Nation.
Shout out CHH Nation.
Make sure y'all check out chhnation.com.
Peace!
You are locked in the CHH Nation.
Make sure y'all check out chhnation.com.
Make sure you check out chhnation.com.
They also said to tell you that go to chhnation.com. Is that how you spell it?
Is that the site?
Is that the site?
Yeah, okay, cool. So y'all make sure y'all go over there.
Pay me
sure.
in a check.
They're gonna put up anything to do with the album. You already know what it is. Social Club, we out.
Peace.
Good luck.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up for KB! We'll be right back.
go off.
An open microphone can be dangerous.
You think me and me is weak, huh? You try me and me call weak. Ain't that right, Jack?
Hands up! Say that! Say
hey!
Say that! Say that! Say hey! Say that! Say that! Say that! Say that!
I go out.
I go out. I go out. I go out. I go out. I go out. I go out.
I don't care if it ended a little bit shorter. I don't care if I worked
so hard that I found myself more tired towards the end. I don't care. I just want to be able to say with one of my favorite missionaries that my life was exhausted for the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen, all the rest I will ever need awaits me after this life is over. But right now, we work and we work for His glory. I promise. All I really know is 100, 100, nothing less, 100 till nothing left. All I really know is 100, 100, nothing less, 100 till nothing left. Hold on one second. Listen, I love rapping. It is so fun. When we do these songs, my prayer is that you will connect with what's being said. It is more than just getting hype. And all of our energy is expressing our worship to God. Tonight, two things are going to happen. Number one, let's address something. I'm not the performer right now. You're not the audience. God is the audience watching us right now. I'm going to take this sweater like so. When this sweater hits that ground, I want to see you lose your mind like the angels are watching. Can we do that? When this sweater hits that ground, turn up so far, we'll have to pull you down from that ceiling. You ready for this? Oh, yeah. Some of y'all are scared over here. Y'all ready for this?
Yeah. respect. In that moment, we'll all be worthy. Cause my work is worship. When it comes back for us, church all over the earth. And we give it no less than what he gave us first.
Shut those doors back, then that'd be great. All eyes on me, all eyes on me.
Listen, there's a sister in our community. Some of you have heard of her. Her name is Jasmine Lachey. If you've never heard of Jasmine Lachey, it's probably because you haven't heard my first album. And I just want to say something to you straight up. I forgive you. And you can make it right in Walmart or that table out there. I'm joking, I don't bring it, I'm just joking. No, for real, make sure you do that. Anyways, say talk to us, KB. Jasmine Lachey's story has had great impact on my life. When she was 15 or so, she heard some news. She heard the news that her heart needed to be replaced or she would die. No medication, no rest. She needed a new heart or it would be over. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was 15 years old, I had plans for my life. Wanted to marry a supermodel. Wanted to make sure I had me a huge house with 1.5 kids and a Mercedes-Benz and the driveway. That was my plan. So the hint of that might be taken from me would have been too much to bear. But now for Jasmine. All eyes on me. This sister said, before she heard this news, she heard some other news. A few years later, a few years before, that Jesus Christ comes into the world to save sinners. And if they believe, they'll get a new life that goes beyond the life they have right now. She heard that. So when this new news came in, she wasn't utterly destroyed. Matter of fact, she had this unusual strength that was shocking to those around her. I'm sure her family's freaking out. Our baby girl is dying. And she had this solid faith that folks didn't know was coming from. One of the nurses said to her, you know what your problem is, Jasmine? You don't think you're gonna die. You're in denial. And in her young mind, she said to that nurse, listen, what God has for me is mine. It's like this. If I live, I'm with him. If I die, I'm with him. So you tell me the better part of that equation. I will be okay regardless. So talk to us, KB. I don't know about you, but that, for me, makes God look extremely attractive. There's a lot of stuff, a lot of remedies in this world. But nothing comes close to having you face death with confidence that it is already beaten. There's nothing else there except Jesus. She had this. And that encouraged me so much. And I love to share that story because it makes God look good because he actually is. So good that I can never exaggerate and talk about blessings and extra job or lights can be cut off or something like that. I get that, but he does the small and the great. He's good all the way across the board. By the Lord's grace, Jasmine Lachey got that heart transplant. Name moved to the top of the list. She was fine. The average lifespan of a heart transplant is about 15 years. A few years ago, Jasmine was in year around 13, 14. Nobody really said it, but it looked like the clock was ticking against her. So, I see her walking around church. I don't really know what to say, so I walk up, hey Jasmine, how you doing? Confidence. I'm well, KB. God has me. Now that second piece that she told us about, that sounded almost fairy tale-ish. I saw it in her. That same strength that she told us about, I saw it in her. When I went to the hospital to visit her, I saw it. By the Lord's grace, once again, her name was moved to the top of the list and she got that heart transplant. Yesterday, 2 days ago, we did a music video and we raised money for her. I thought it was $10,000. We actually raised $50,000 for this girl. But I hear the echo of what Job said. Though he slay me, I will still praise him in that woman's actions. What is that? I tell you what it is. It's a God who is so good, you cannot find the bottom of this wonderful God. You can't do it. He's so good, words are always falling woefully short of describing who he is. He is better than the greatest thought you could ever think of him. He's that good. But if that's true, and the necessary consequence is also true. If it's so good to be with him, if God is for you, nothing can be against you. If God is against you, it doesn't matter what you got going for you. Oh, as good it is to know him, that's just how bad it is to reject him. This isn't a game. Listen, you and I not only reject God, but God is rejecting us because of that rejection. He is not okay with us. We are in a place where we try to make it right ourselves. Like, I'm not going to get drunk anymore. Well, check it. You're not going to be able to stay sober long enough to make up for the fact that you got drunk in the first place. You can't stop sinning long enough to make up for the fact that you transgressed God's law once. Because of that, you and I are in trouble. Uh-huh. The Bible says in Psalm 75 that there's like a cup of wrath that's boiling at the top. And that this cup, almost as if it gets stronger, every time we sin, this wine in it is strengthening. And one day the Bible says he's going to take that cup and pour it out on the wicked. And it says they will drink it down to the dregs, down to the bottom. And we know what the Bible teaches. This is harsh stuff. The Bible teaches that you will never find the bottom of that cup. It will take eternity in hell to find the bottom of the wrath of God. That's scary. But God is not only angry with us. He's also kind, loving, patient, and long-suffering. And this God, in that, sent his son, Jesus Christ, to live 33 years perfectly. Never sinned, never needed mercy, never needed grace, never needed any sort of forgiveness. He gave all three of them. He got on a cross, and on the cross he was on a mission. It was in the fact that he was taking that cup that had your name written on it. It was destined for you. He takes that cup and he writes his name over it. And he takes that cup and he drinks it, and by the grace of Almighty God, he finds the bottom of the cup in 3 hours. Flips the cup over. He flips the cup over and he says it is finished. This Jesus dies. He dies. Jesus died. The sinless, perfect Son of God died.
Yes.
The sinners. Sinners say dead. Jesus was no sinner. 3 days later, this Jesus got out of the grave, proving that he was all powerful of sin, Satan, the devil. And he sets a pattern for us. All of life outside of the gospel is trying to keep you from it. Mm. They have been trying for thousands of years to put that tomb over Jesus. They put guards outside the tomb. Everything in the media is designed to keep us from understanding what is the big issues of life. We think it's being successful or sexy or famous. Being known. That's the trick. Our biggest issue is that we have a cup with our name on it. Unless Christ drinks it, we will perish.
Right.
But he did. Hold it.